St. Edward's University Chorale and the St. Edward's University Madrigal Singers. I'd like to ask you at this moment to, if you would, find all of those electronic devices and make sure, please, that they are in the off position and that they would not be wanting to make any kind of other noise that we would have. We're waiting on just a couple of folks to make sure that they're coming in and getting an opportunity to have seated. Good, come on in, welcome. Very, very fine. This evening's program is going to be featuring music that both choirs have been working on together. Some of the music that you will hear this evening will also be performed by our Masterworks ensemble with these groups combined. And that concert will be coming up on November the 9th, and we'll talk more about that concert later. But for now, I'd like for you to relax and enjoy some beautiful choral music. I'd like to bring on our accompanist. She's already there. My name is Dr. Maura Stevens, and we open this evening with My Song in the Night by Meg Wilbur.
Thank you.
first is by Palestrina, and it is the Agnus Dei movement from his Missa Beata Assumpta Est. And this particular work is a wonderful, wonderful example of the Renaissance style and the mastery of Palestrina. And as I've told the students, this particular style is so amazing because in many pieces of more modern music, we all hear a melody. And most of the time, the melody in choral music might be in some of the upper voices, and everyone else has a harmonic point. In this particular piece, and in this wonderful period of music, every single part has the melody. And so the harmony is a result of these interweaving melodies together. So we hope that you enjoy.
Thank you.
change over now, and we will feature our Madrigal Chamber Singers. I need to say a few words about this next set of pieces. C.M. Shearer is a very, very, very special man to Texas, and then he went on to Nebraska. He's just a wonderful, wonderful person in American choral music history. May he rest in peace. He died very, very, very too much too early. But in the years that he was here in Texas, he became a wonderful choral and record and beautiful teacher, and was responsible, really, for the growth of musical literacy and his attention to musical literacy and the teaching of musical literacy throughout the state of Texas. The Texas Choral Directors Association, which is one of the largest, or it is the largest group of choral directors across the country, commissioned him with their very, very first commission in 1993 to write this piece of music to be premiered at their annual summer convention by a group of choral directors. And so he took this amazing set of texts called Children's Letters to God and set this tremendous six-movement work. Now, don't get crazy. We're not going to be here until midnight with six movements, because these are tiny little miniatures, and they just really, really captured the idea of what a child would do in writing their letters to God. So take yourself back to maybe your first or second grade classroom. My wife is a first grade teacher. And take yourself back to that assignment that she might have given you and say, we'd like for you to write a letter to God. And it can be about anything. And so these entire letters that were very, very, very numerous in nature, he narrowed down to these individual six movements. Please feel free that when you hear the text to react. We're not necessarily in this particular time here something that it's like a library. If you hear something that is going to grab your attention, go ahead and react to it. And then I think that you'll find also there's some beautiful poignancy to it. So we're very, very, very happy to bring you Professor C.M. Shearer's Children's Letters to God.
Thank you.
another amazing text by Sarah Teasdale, Grace Before Sleep. And we've had such a marvelous, marvelous time with this composer, Susan Labar, another very young American composer who has risen on the horizon over the last maybe 5 years, and is just doing some absolutely marvelous, marvelous choral composing. I think she's decided to go off and be a mom, and so she's taken a little hiatus, but I hope that once the children get to be old enough and where they can go into nursery or whatever, that she continues to write. So I'm really, really, really encouraging her in emails and that. There's lots of folks that are encouraging her to continue to give us these wonderful, beautiful compositions and arrangements. Susan Labar's Grace Before Sleep.
Thank you.
spoke about C.M. Shearer being commissioned by the Texas Choral Directors Association, it's important that everybody understands what a commission is. Commission is where a body goes to a composer and invites that composer to literally compose a piece specifically for a group or a particular performance. And we are absolutely just thrilled and overjoyed here at St. Edward's University that we now have our own commissioning project. And thanks to the Edward D. Anderson Choral Foundation and Choral Support, and Dr. Anderson is here tonight and is a member of our Masterwork Singers as well too. But we also need to all thank him, the students and us, for having such a marvelous, marvelous vision to start. First two came from one composer, and he wrote a two-movement work. This particular composer, Frank Tekeli, is an American composer who, and you can read about his bio in your program. We placed a short bio of him in the program. But he's an amazing composer who has been worldwide known as an instrumental composer. And every wind ensemble, professional ensemble of orchestras and wind ensembles of universities and all down into to the secondary school levels. He is known all across this world for his magnificent, magnificent instrumental compositions. He has, up until now, about five pieces of choral music, and each one of those five pieces were absolutely stunning. And so we went to him and asked him if he would entertain the idea of composing a piece for St. Edward's, and he thankfully said yes. But we also gave him the challenge of writing a piece which could be performed by a full string orchestra, which is allowing his instrumental talents to shine, and then combining his choral talents. I forgot to mention that all of those other five pieces, those very few pieces that he had written, every single one of them up to this point in time had been set for a cappella voices. So we'd never ventured into this area. And so we were very, very fortunate that he said yes, and so he has now given us this piece. You all tonight are going to hear a teaser. We like to call this our trailer performance, our movie trailer performance. The full official world premiere will be given on November the 9th at St. Vincent de Paul Church in Austin. And we invite you all to attend that, and I'm sure that some of you will. Many of you all will be performing in that group, because I see a good number of Masterwork Singers here. We take our Masterwork Singers, our community chorus, these wonderful fine singers of our undergraduate choirs, and we combine them all together with a professional string orchestra to give you this marvelous, marvelous new piece. Tonight, we will sing up until the time in the work that he initially set the initial title of the piece, struggling with what to title the piece. He wrote the poetry as well. And so we've given you the insert of the poetry to follow along. You'll be able to read the full poem, and we just won't give you all the music yet tonight. But we're very, very, very excited to give you the piano and choral version of the first section of Until Forever Fades Away by Frank Tekeli. Thank you. lots of weddings. You hear it a lot at Christmas time. He wrote this entire piece called Missa Brevis Indeed, and in really quick explanation, in comparison with other composers who write Missa Brevis, or Missa Brevi, many of those composers, later composers, Mozart, for example, would take the text and would have one part singing some of the longer parts of the text, and he would stack text upon one another, and thereby shorten the piece. Paco Bell's Missa Brevis is only 3 of 5 movements. He only finished the 3 movements. And so we sing the first 2 movements for you this evening, Kyrie and Gloria in Excelsis, from Paco Bell's Missa Brevis.
Thank you.
concert of our year of 2018. We'd like to close this evening with Peter Boyer's On Music's Wings. each other's necks on the way out. Hug these folks' necks if you're related to them, and thank them. Very, very, very.